Tonight on Access TV, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Jim Mendrinos, Luis J. Gomez, Nick Vatterott, Wil Sylvince. This week's host, Anjelah Johnson. Gotham Comedy Live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Anjelah Johnson.
Thank you. Thank you so much, you guys. Welcome to Gotham Comedy Live. We've got a great show for you guys tonight. Before we jump right in, I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I just got married 2 years ago. Blank, blank. Don't be fooled by the rocks that I got, you guys. I'm still Jenny from the Black. Well, I'm Angie from the Black, actually. You guys, I'm not fancy, though. I promise. I'll tell you how fancy I'm not. I live in Los Angeles, so I have to do, like, these red carpet events, right, where you get dressed up nice, and you walk the red carpet, and they take pictures of you, and they go, Anjelah, who are you wearing? I go, oh, Forever 21. I got these at Claire's. It was like a 5-pack. You could borrow it if you want. Go for it. I'm not fancy, you guys. And when I first started telling people I got married, a lot of people were surprised. They were like, what? Oh my God, I didn't even know you. I thought you were a lesbian. Surprise. Ponytails because I'm lazy, not lazy. Totally got you. And people ask me, like, who's your husband? Who is this guy? Tell us about him, right? Well, it's actually kind of funny because I used to do a joke a while back about Christian rap music and Christian rappers, how, like, it's so cheesy. Like, for real, what are you going to do? Bust a cap in the devil? Right? Like, what's your name? Ludacrist? Coming to the stage, Jay-Zeezus. Jehovah. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, white guy, for getting the Jehovah reference. People say my husband looks like Lenny Kravitz. Well, white people say he looks like Lenny Kravitz. Black people say he looks like Maxwell. It just depends on what neighborhood you're from. A lot of times, white people don't know who Maxwell is. They're like, what? Maxwell? Coffee? He looks like coffee? I don't get this joke. Any black guy with an afro, he looks like him a little bit. But the funny thing is, he's not even black, he's Puerto Rican. Got some Puerto Ricans here tonight? Puerto Ricans? Ooh, thank you for coming. Thank you for coming, sir. Thank you for clapping. Appreciate it, you guys. A lot of times, people who are not Latino tend to think that all Latinos are the same, right? But we're pretty different, you guys. You don't realize how different Mexicans are from Puerto Ricans until you sign up to marry one. Very different. Even the little things, right? Like, I'm Mexican. Any Mexicans here in New York? Oh, that's right, you're from Mexico. Thank you for coming. It's me, you, and her. What are we doing here in New York? I don't know how we got here. So I'm Mexican, right? And I like spicy food. I eat salsa with everything. Like, if you don't got salsa for your food, probably just don't even eat it. You know what I'm saying? Just get a smoothie. For real, like you go to your friend's house for dinner, you're like, oh, you don't got no salsa? I'll be back, I'm gonna go with Jamba Juice real quick. And my husband, he's Puerto Rican, right? He doesn't do spicy food. Like, if you sprinkle a little bit of pepper in his food, he's gonna flip out. Babe, is this spicy? You put spice in this? You put your Mexican stuff in this? Like, it's pepper, you can't handle pepper? My family calls me Mija. His family calls me Mami. The Spanish is so different. The way Mexicans speak Spanish, the way Puerto Ricans speak Spanish is very different, right? And I live in Los Angeles, so it's like northern Mexico right there. So that's the only kind of Spanish that I hear, right? And then Puerto Ricans, y'all are from Orlando, I think. So when I first flew to Orlando to meet his mom, she started speaking to me in Spanish. I was like, oh, sorry, I don't speak Puerto Rican. I don't know what that means. It just sounds different, right? Like to me, when I hear Puerto Ricans speak Spanish, it sounds like they have water in their mouth and they don't want it to spill. You know what I mean? Like, hola, ¿cómo está? ¿Cómo? Oye, ¿qué está pasando? Ah. It just sounds different. I mean, I'm not really one to be talking because I don't even speak Spanish, so. My last name's Johnson, what do you want me to do? And my husband and I decided we didn't want any kids, right? We're like, no, 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 no kids, no kids, no kids. I know, it's very un-Mexican to me, but. And I take it over the top, too. Like, if I see a pregnant girl walking towards me, I'm like, oh, no, 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 no. Like, I don't want her pregnant vibes to jump on me. If one of them sneaks past me and I missed her, I catch her at the last second, all holding my breath, like, whoo, close one. No, thank you. We got enough nieces, nephews, cousins, godkids. I got a lot of godkids. I don't know if it's a Mexican thing to double up on your godkids, but I got a lot. And like my friend, he had a baby, right? And he asked me to be the godmother, to be her Nina. I was like, yeah, I'll be her Nina, right? But then he kept having more kids, and now they all call me Nina. And I was like, I'm pretty sure I only signed up for one. Do I gotta get them all a Christmas gift now? Like, I don't know how that works. I got god dogs. I got all kind of people waiting to live with me when their parents die. All my god dogs are like Maltese something, like Maltese poodle, Maltese lhasa apso, Maltese shih tzu, like all kind of Maltese, right? And then all my god kids are Filipino, right? Like, I, my goddaughters are Italian and Filipino. My godson, Puerto Rican and Filipino. So basically, if you want to be one of my godkids, you got to be the Maltese or Filipino. And that's how you make my team, right? Any Filipinos here? Filipinos here tonight? One, thank you for coming. I appreciate you. Proud wave. I appreciate your proud wave. Oh, you're only half, so that's why you didn't give it your all. Just half Filipino. I have a lot of Filipino friends. And one of my good friends, she's Filipino, and one day her grandma was driving, and she probably shouldn't have been, but she was. And so she's driving, right? And all of a sudden, she hit a dog. I know, it's really sad, especially for me, because I have god dogs. So she's driving, and she hit a dog, but her response to that was, "Oi, sorry, dog." So at least she apologized. Oi, sorry, dog. So now I just use that in everyday life. Like if I trip over something, I'm like, oi, sorry, dog. So yeah, my husband and I, we don't want no kids. No kids at all. And one thing I've learned about my husband since we've been married, right, is we have different rules, different ways of doing things, right? Like, for instance, like my toothbrush, right? See, I like to be the only one that uses my toothbrush. This guy, I don't know how he grew up. Like, maybe they're on a budget or something. But like, he came to me one day, he was like, hey babe, can I use your toothbrush real quick? I said, for what? Like, that's an option for you? Like, you're thinking about it? Sick. He said, what? It's just like kissing. We kiss, it's the same thing. Oh no, I do not scrape off your tartar with my tongue. And I'm almost positive I cannot prevent cavities. You guys, I'm Anjelah Johnson. We got a great show lined up for you guys tonight. So stay tuned right after this.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Jim Mendrinos is taking the stage when we return.
Hey.
Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
All right, you guys, our next comic up. You have seen him on BBC America. Please welcome Jim Mendrinos.
Awesome. Wow. You know what? Screw the set. Do that again. That was awesome. I love that. Great. That is better than a nap right there. More invigorating than... I love naps. Are you with me on that? Oh, man. I love it. I can sleep 10 hours, wake up, have a bowl of cereal, nap for 4 more hours. If I do anything challenging, like touch myself, there could be a 6-hour power nap involved. There are some days I've done nothing but ejaculate and sleep, I'll be honest with you. I don't know why I looked right at you for that joke. That was kind of creepy. It was a little creepy, but we'll deal with it. It's a beautiful day. We're at a club. Sit back, drink. I used to drink tequila. That's a nasty drink, isn't it? You drink too much tequila, you'll start answering questions nobody even asked you. Hey, Bob, what time is it? I got 4 kids. And my car's blue. Don't you tell me nothing. Women and tequila, that's a lovely mix, isn't it? Ladies, you drink too much tequila, you lose every bit of morality you've ever accumulated. You're pounding on the men's room door like, hey, somebody fuck me. Ladies are laughing, guys are looking up like, does that work? Nasty drink. You drink too much tequila, next morning about 10 minutes after you cease vomiting, the phone rings. Always a mysterious yet familiar voice saying something like, dude, you were real messed up. It's followed by the single most frightening phrase in the English language, you wouldn't believe what you did. God, I hate that phrase. You know why? Because I know whenever I hear it, I was in my underwear on the table going, I am the walrus goo 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 choo. Because nobody has ever called you up to tell us something nice you did when you were drunk. Just one time I want someone to call me up like, hey, Jim, remember that time you got shit-faced and you painted the orphanage? Find this out. All right, we'll hold with that. Okay, you get just so drunk, you wake up the next morning, you're still wearing the same pants, shirt, and shoes from the night before, but you have absolutely no idea where your underwear went. It's a good night drinking right there, is all I'm telling you. Drunk stories, we all got drunk stories. Here's a clue. If you don't got a drunk story, chances are you are someone's drunk story. Here's how you can tell. People start chuckling whenever they see you pick up a beer. You the story. Greatest drunk story I ever heard was Dennis Rodman. For those of you that don't know, Dennis Rodman, basketball player, one time got drunk, hopped on a plane, flew to Vegas, and married Carmen Electra. Fuck it, he wins. You know why I say that? I'll tell you why. Because I've been a blackout drunk for most of my adult life, and never, not once, did I ever wake up next to anyone who even remotely resembled Carmen Electra. On occasion, I walk next to people that look like Dennis Rodman, but... Man, interesting year for me. I'm single again, which is, that's an ugly phrase, isn't it?
No.
Single, that's an ugly, it's like the cancer came back, same kind of phrase. It is. Yeah. Jim, heard you single. Yep, thought it was in remission, turns out. It's been a weird year. You know what was the weirdest part about being single? I had to reconstitute an entire apartment, like buy everything from scratch. And here's the weird thing. I realized there are things that I had never done as an adult. Like, I actually had to buy sheets. And I realized that I have never in my life purchased sheets at all. Let me explain to you how I got to this point, okay? When I was 16, I moved out of my parents' house and I moved into an apartment with 5 guys, and my mom came over one day, she looked at the way we were living and she went, this is disgusting, and she went out and she bought me some sheets. And then I got a girlfriend and she looked at the sheets my mom bought and went, those are disgusting, and she went out and she bought me sheets. And every girlfriend I've ever been with has bought me new sheets because the one before had shitty taste. Cut to, I am 48 years old, I am standing at Macy's trying to buy sheets and I have no idea what I'm doing. Here's how I knew I was overmatched. I said to the guy behind the counter, I need some sheets. The guy goes, what size is your bed? And I'm like, I got no idea. Vente, grande, help me out here, dude. Here's how pathetic I was. He actually walked me to the beds so I could point at the size bed I had like a lost five-year-old looking for his mommy. Like, that one. He said, like, queen size. I'm like, woo, okay. So he comes back and he lays out an array of sheets, just like seven sets of sheets. Boom, 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 boom. Look at me. Do I look like I could tell the difference between those seven sets of sheets? Let's be really honest. Do I even look like I sleep on sheets? If I told you people I slept on crumpled up copies of the New York Post, you'd look at me like, that's about right. So I'm there like, dude, just pick one. And he goes, well, this one, it's Egyptian cotton and it's 350 thread count. You should get these, the best sheets we got. I'm like, just wrap it up. I don't need the story. He's like, you should know, it's $275 for the set. And I'm like, fuck you hard. Do you have any idea what I'm gonna be doing on those sheets? Between the sweating and the farting and the other assorted bodily fluids? No, I am not paying $275 for something that can be used as DNA evidence. So here's what I did. I had the size now, so I took my ass over to Walmart and I bought a set of sheets for $9. Yeah, 120 thread count, which is also number 12 sandpaper. If I jump into bed too quickly, I actually exfoliate. Started dating again. Dating's weird. I wanted to date somebody old-fashioned. I went on a very old-fashioned date with a lady. We went to dinner and a movie. That's about as old-fashioned as you can get, you know what I'm saying? We literally walked back home holding hands. It's adorable, you know what I'm saying? Linking pinkies on the way home. Yeah, here's the thing. If you're linking pinkies, you're not bumping uglies. That's for sure. We get all the way back. I give her a little kiss goodnight at her door. We make plans to see each other again. Old-fashioned, I'm comfortable with this. 3.5 hours later, 2 a.m, my cell phone beeps, text message, and it says, send me a picture of your dick. Apparently, she was not as old-fashioned as I believed. To which I replied, no. You know why? Because she had not yet seen it in real life, and it felt way too much like an audition. Like, I would send her the picture, she'd look at it like, next. Here's a piece of advice. Ladies, if you ever ask a guy for a picture of his penis and you have not yet seen it in real life, he's not gonna send it to you. The best he is gonna send you is a picture of somebody else's much more impressive penis, which is exactly what I did at that moment. And she knew it too, because she goes, that's not your penis. I'm like, how do you know? She goes, because you're not black. You don't know me. That happens to be my big black dick. I have that imported. I am actually dating now. I met a very nice woman, and we're going out. And she's black, which works out well because my parents are dead. And there you go. Yeah, you weren't expecting that one, I know. They weren't dead till after we told them, but it still works out, so. Did the vacation thing this year. I took a couple of minutes on a little vacation. I went up to Montreal. If you haven't been to Montreal, you gotta go to Montreal. You know why I say that? Because everyone in Montreal is gorgeous. Man, woman, child, everyone in the city of Montreal is absolutely stunning, which is amazing, because not more than 30 miles away from there, in Plattsburgh, New York, the ugliest people I have ever seen. No, really, there are genetic experiments gone awry in Plattsburgh. And meanwhile, supermodels just meander the streets of Montreal. Here's how good looking they are in Montreal. I was reasonably sure they were not gonna let me in the city. Like, I was gonna get there and there'd be a mountie like, Monsieur, where are you going? Montreal. You? No. You go to Plattsburgh. And I know I don't exactly look like a comedian or a guy that should be in Montreal. I don't even look like a comedian. You know what I look like? I look like a cross-country driver that kills hookers in truck stops. That's what I look like. Guys, it's been a lot of fun. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your night. You guys are awesome. Thank you. You guys are great. Well, I am so sorry about that.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Luis J. Gomez is taking the stage when we return.
All right, everybody. From right code, please welcome Luis J. Gomez.
I feel like you guys aren't even really applauding for me. My buddy texted me this the other day. He's like, hey man, I want to come over and play some video games. What are you doing? So I texted him back, fucking A, dude. But I didn't use a comma, so it just said fucking a dude. Yeah, I haven't spoken to my buddy in a week. I'm not gonna lie, guys. It's gotten pretty weird. It is not the same relationship that it was before I sent that text message. That joke was so good that she just slammed a beer into the table. That was a good joke, you're right. I'm a parent now. Any other parents in the crowd? Clap your hands, parents. Just a sad applause. It really changes your perspective being a parent, right? Let me ask the guys a question. Guys, what's more important to you on a woman, beautiful face or beautiful body? What do you say? Face. No idea, face. I agree, I say face. I'll tell you why, you gotta think about this shit. If you're with a woman, you might have a baby with her one day. You have a baby with this woman, you wanna make sure your baby has a cute face. Nobody cares about your baby's body. Nobody's like, my baby's got a whatever face, but he's got a really fat ass, so. He's got great muscle tone, he's got pecs, abs, got those hot little indentations right there, wears his diaper real low. My baby is lean, are you kidding me? Face of a dog. My son is really cute, man. He's gonna be 11 months old this month, and he's probably the cutest baby I've ever seen. Let me tell you how cute he is. Do me a favor, all the parents in the crowd, imagine your baby's face. Now imagine a baby 15 times as cute. That's my baby. He is really cute, like way cuter than your babies. He's so cute that it's uncomfortable when people bring their average looking babies around us. Like, I gotta pretend that their baby is cute like mine, and it's not. Like, I wanna be honest. I wanna be like, ew, get your gross baby away from mine. You're bringing down the property value. Yeah, your baby's like a 6. Any guys in the crowd have a son? Guys with a son, clap your hands. There. Wait, let me ask you a question, sir. Would you care if your son was gay? Not at all? Not even a little bit? Are you saying that because there's a camera in your face? Listen, man, I used to say that I wouldn't care, but I know I would care. I mean, not if your son was gay. I don't care if your son's gay. Your son can go be a fucking ballerina for all I care. I would care if my son was gay. I have a lot of gay friends. I used to say that I wouldn't, but something happened in my life. I'll tell you what happened. I got a dog named Sport, and I brought him to the dog park like a month ago. He started humping this other male dog. Now the dog's owner is like, yo son, your dog is gay. It broke my fucking heart, guys. And that was my dog, so I know I would care if my son was gay. It hit me like a bullet to the chest. I got really defensive and angry. I was like, don't call my dog gay. Your dog's gay. He's just sitting there taking it. My dog is just dominating your gay dog like a man would. Gave my dog a high five. We started making fun of the other dog. Come on, Sport, let's go pick up some bitches. I got a crazy family. My sister is rude as shit. She got me a sun visor for Christmas last year. Which is a stupid gift in December. It's just a cold month. It's stupid. But I'm going bald, and a sun visor really just accentuates the problem area. It really highlights my main insecurity for everyone walking by to point and laugh at on Christmas morning. That's messed up, right? It's okay, though, because I'm going to get her back. Here's how. Christmas is right around the corner, and she's fat. So I'm buying her a sweater with a big hole cut out right in the stomach area. so everyone can point and laugh at her gut. I just realized there's three black people in this crowd. How racist is this show? What the fuck is going on? How uncomfortable is that? My mom was racist as shit. She didn't care. I'm half Puerto Rican, half Italian. My mom did not give a shit. I had a Jewish friend in high school. She told me I couldn't be friends with them. I'm like, why not? She's like, because the Jews control all the banks and all the media in the world. I was like, Mom, you married a Puerto Rican. We're on welfare. We need some Jews in our life right fucking now. Are you insane? All of the banks. I'm going to marry a Jewish chick. Get me a bank. I'll tell you guys my saddest joke. This is it. My father was stabbed when I was 4 years old. He was stabbed when I was a kid. That's sad. I have two other friends. I have a friend named Victor Garcia. His dad was stabbed when he was a kid. I have a friend named Joe Santiago. His dad was stabbed when he was a kid. All three of us are Hispanic. All three of our fathers were stabbed. Here's what's hilarious. All three of us have been accused of acting like we're white our entire lives. And I was thinking about this. I don't think we're acting like we're white. I think that we're like evolving to not get fucking stabbed. You know what I'm talking about? You guys get what I'm saying? Like, I'm surviving. This is just science. White people live till they're like 90 without stabbing each other. It's actually pretty impressive. You know what? Bravo, white people, for not having the urge to stab each other, guys. Seriously. That was really meant for the brown people to start clapping, but this guy got very excited. You see his face? He's like, you know what, buddy? We are pretty good at not stabbing each other. This guy's fucking up there saying some shit. Yeah, man. I got anger problems, too. I'm an angry dude. Anybody else in the crowd angry? Let's go over here. I'm an angry man. Here's what's funny. When I get angry, I lose control of my words. So I say ridiculous shit. My mouth just goes. I don't think about what I'm going to say. I had a guy at a bar recently tried to fight me. He's like, yeah, motherfucker, suck my dick. And I was mad, so I wasn't thinking. So I was like, why don't we go outside and I'll suck that dick. That's not even talking shit. That's just me offering to suck some dude's dick. Confidently. What's up, motherfucker? Your dick my throat outside now. He had two friends with him. I was like, I'll suck his dick. I'll suck his dick. I'll suck every dick in this place. You kidding me? People think I'm tough because I'm like a big Latino dude. I got scars across both my hands, so people see my hands sometimes and they're like, oh shit, this guy must know how to fight. But it's not a badass story at all. I'll tell you what happened. I was in the pool at my gym. I was in one lane. There was this really hot chick in the lane right next to me taking a swim lesson. Smoking hot chick. And I wanted to show off my swimming skills for her. That was the idea. I wanted to show off that I was a good swimmer, okay? So the plan was go underwater, kick off the wall, do like a graceful one of these out into like one of those. And then just swim. That was the whole plan, okay? What I actually did was I went underwater, kicked off the wall, scraped my knuckles along the bottom of the pool floor. I came up with my hands bleeding. I looked like a fat Wolverine. I was like, ah! The hot girl just shit herself in the pool. It was a mess, guys. You don't even know. I'm a huge UFC fan. UFC is my favorite sport. I love mixed martial arts. It really has changed shit for men, because now any guy gets to look tough, you know? You know, all you need, it's a style. All you need is like an affliction shirt or a tap out shirt. Nobody's gonna fuck with that guy because he might be a cage fighter. It's smart. So when I go out, I just wear a karate uniform. I carry a trophy. I'm like, what's up, motherfucker? I just won second place in nationals. Why don't you step to this shit? If they step to you, hit him with a trophy and get the fuck out of there. Now, you guys have been a great crowd. Thank you so much. I'm Luis J. Gomez.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Nick Vatterott is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs right now.
You guys ready for some more comedy? Our next comic you have seen on Comedy Central, please welcome Nick Vatterott.
Nice. All right. Hello, folks. Thank you. You guys are great. I hate when strangers on the street ask me for directions. So what I do now is someone's like, sir, do you know where McDonald's is? I go, McDonald's? That burned down 14 years ago. Then just slowly back up into traffic. It's fine. Just got back from Missouri, my home state. A couple people. It's great. Missouri, as that's actually how they say it. They say Missouri down there. They say Warsh. I Warsh myself. That's very funny. I think it's funny that people pronounce words different throughout the country. You know, and like in New York, you say, I wash myself. In Missouri, they say, I wash myself. In Arkansas, they say, I never wash myself. Isn't that weird? In fact, if you go far enough south, they pronounce every word different. And I read there's actually a term for that. It's called Spanish. Isn't that interesting? I was down in Mexico recently, Puerto Vallarta. I wanted to ask this guy what time it was. I go up to the guy. I'm going over the phrase in my head. I'm like, all right, I think I got this. I go, hola, que es, what time it is? I just bailed on it halfway through. Here's the best part. The guy looks at me and goes, yeah, it's 4:45. Just spoke perfect. But I felt like I'd already kind of committed to the character. I was like, oh, okay, thank you. I'm going to see how far I can walk in the ocean now. Where'd you say you were from? Everywhere. I hate buying stuff in other countries, man. Other countries have so many coins. I was just in Canada. They got pennies, nickels, dimes, quarters, dollars, $2 coins. You know, you're only there for 3 days. You're drunk the whole time. You got to wrap your mind around the entire currency system. You got a line of people behind you. All the coins look the same. I feel like a little kid buying stuff for the first time, you know? I'm like, is it this much? Is it this many? You do it. Then they give me change, and I just have to trust them. I don't, you know. They give me whatever. They just give me a handful of marbles and washers, and I'll be like, thank you. This is their way. You ever walk into a store, like a small mom-and-pop shop, and the second you get in there, you realize you don't want to be in there? But it's too awkward to leave right away. So you wind up fake shopping for a couple minutes. You walk in, it's like, gling, gling. Oh, this is all crap. This is all, what is this, a garage sale inside? What is this place? And the person working is always the nicest person ever, you know? Hi, my only customer ever, hi. All my hopes and dreams are in your wallet. Can I help you with anything? Nah, I'm just gonna walk around, try to figure out how you stay in business. Weirdest store I've ever been into. This is a real store. It was in Italy, and all they sold were guns and birds. Isn't that the weird? I took like 20 pictures. It was like they had some like brass knuckles, some nunchucks, but for the most part, they just had exotic. They'd be like a row of parrots and then a row of like pistols and semi-automatic weapons. It's like the weirdest combination of things, you know? I wish I spoke Italian, because I would love to understand what the conversations at the transaction were, you know? Just some guy's like, hey, how you doing? Can I get two parakeets and a shotgun? How many bullets? Two's fine. Oh, I don't need a bag. Gling, gling, gling. Hi. Do you have any slower birds? Faster bullets or anything like that? No? God. All right. Do you know where I can get a turtle and a sword? Oh, Tony's Turtles and Swords? Right across the street. All right. Sounds good. Check it out. Go to Italy. Have that be the only thing you do there. You're gonna be able to buy weed in stores soon, I think. We're on that path. Some people are really still against marijuana, which is weird. I don't understand why marijuana is illegal and alcohol, everyone's fine with alcohol being legal, you know? Alcohol's way worse, you know? Like, they're both, I love them both, they're both terrible for you. But alcohol's way worse for society than marijuana is. You know, alcohol is the leading cause for domestic violence in our country. Marijuana is the leading cause of, I don't know, songs being 20 minutes long. You know? Like, what would you rather have? You know, a world where a kid grows up, he's like, when I was a kid, my dad used to come home, get drunk, and beat me. Or a world where a kid grows up, he's like, when I was a kid, my dad used to come home, get high, and eat pancakes. And he tried to remember what he was just talking about for hours at a time. One time, when I was at its worst, I walked into the den, and he had just realized he was looking at a map upside down for 20 minutes. And that's when he started laughing till he fell asleep. Although you never get existentially confused from alcohol, though. One time I was super high, walked into my kitchen to see what time it was, looked at the microwave clock, and it just said end. Hey, Nick, what time is it? I think that's it, man. I think we used them all up, man. Or my pancakes are done, one of the two. I suck with technology, man. I suck. I got a girl's number on a Monday recently. At least I tell myself I did. I got a number on a Monday. We don't talk all week. Friday, I get a voicemail from her. She's like, hey, I'm at my place. You want to hang out? I text her because I'm driving and that's safer. I'm joking. I don't text and drive. I'm normally too drunk. I can't do that. Is that right? I text her. I go, who is this? Ha, ha, ha. I'm coming to get you. It was the best thing I could think of. I immediately get a text back that says, thank you for using text to landline services. Your text message has been converted into an automated voice message. Which means that she got a message from me that was, who is this? Ha, 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 I'm coming to get you. That's not even the worst one. The worst one is I called up a girl one time. We made it to the first date. First date went well. I waited a couple days to call her because I wanted to be smooth. Smooth is not how it went down. I called her up. I got her voicemail, and it kept cutting out in the message. So this was the message that I hear. Hi, this, after, Then I'm waiting for the beep, and I don't hear the beep. So I don't know if it cut out during the beep or the beep hasn't happened yet, you know? So I'm just sitting there like, what do I do? So eventually I'm like, the beep must have happened. I start talking. Hey, Stace, this is Nick. Just wondering if you wanted to beep. And then I hear the beep. All right, late beep. What do you do? I just started over, you know? Hey, Stace, this is Nick. Just wondering if you wanted to beep. I'm like, I'm panicking now. I tried again. Hey, Stace, this is Nick. Just wondering if you wanted to beep. I'm like, fuck! And I look down. It's my buddy calling on the other line. 8 million apps, there's one tone for anything that happens on the phone. You're supposed to piece it together. That means that she got a message from me that was... Where'd that beep go? Oh, man. This chick is so hot. Stupid flip phone. I hate flip phone. I hate Sprint. Stupid flip phone, man. It must have already happened. I'll just try it. Here we go. Hey, Stace, this is Nick. Just wondering if you wanted to... Hey, Stace, this is Nick. Just wondering if you wanted to... Hey, Stace, this is Nick. Just wondering if you wanted to... Fuck! All right, you guys are amazing. Thank you very much, everybody. You guys rock! I applaud you!
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Wil Sylvince is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
All right, you guys. Our next comic coming up is the founder of Shortcuts Film Festival. Please welcome Wil Sylvince.
What's up, everybody? How y'all doing? I've been traveling a lot. And, you know, when you travel, it makes you appreciate where you come from, you know what I'm saying? I went to London, and I went to the underground, the subway, they call it the underground, and they got a GPS of their train, like, you know, when the next train is coming, the next train, then the next train after that, like six next trains, and a train come every 3 minutes, some bullshit, right? And I realized New York City subway got a way better GPS system than that. This is New York City subway GPS system right here. You can take that anywhere. You can't take this one down and take it with you. And you see this stance I'm doing? I ain't trying to be cool. This ain't a black thing. Just in case there's a person crazy behind me trying to push me on the track. Yo, you trying to push me off the tracks, you asshole? So you got to stand just like this here. And I don't know why we look for the train to see if it's coming, like it's going to come faster. Or the conductor see our face. Who like, hey, yo, it's me. Can you speed it up? I'm running late. He saw my face. He's on his way. You ever waited for the train so long that you look both ways, but I don't care which train come first. I just gotta get on the train. This one come first, I take it all the way to the end and come back around. New York City. Anybody seen that video of that man that was sleeping on the train and the rat came across his face? Yeah. You seen that? For the people who ain't see it, you gotta see it. I'm not making this up. When you go home, Google man on train, rat on face. I'm gonna tell you what happened. There was this man on the number four, six train, knocked out, right? This and a big ass monster rat. The rat had an ass and a Bluetooth, I think, right? The man was knocked out, the rat started coming up his leg, came right on his face and started nibbling on his mouth. The man woke up like, New York rats are so gangster. The rat didn't run, the rat didn't jump. The rat was like, all right, you asleep. I'll be back later. Just. But this how much of a New Yorker this man was. After the rat left, his ass went right back to sleep like. Dude, you can't go back to sleep after a rat bit on your face. Sleep time is over. It's rat patrol time. Cause these loose rats. How bad your life gotta be when the rat come on your face is nothing. It's like a butterfly. Like, oh shit. Was that a butterfly? No, it's a big ass rat. Or a butterfly with a fur coat, you asshole. What the... So the mayor of Toronto said he smoked crack one time, and that was it. He must be on crack saying some shit like that. No one smoked crack one time. Like, it's like saying, you know, I had an orgasm one time, but that was it. It was not for me. I never came back after that. I never had the desire to ever come again. It got cold quick here, right? You know, actually the whole country going through this cold draft. And I remember last year it was cold, way colder than this, and we complaining. The weatherman said last year, today is going to be 7. Tomorrow is going to be 5. I'm like, what the hell is the difference? Are you serious? Just say it's going to be cold as hell. 2 degrees? The next day when it was 5, I'm like, oh shit, he's right. 5 is worse than 7. I know it's going to be this bad. I should wash the shirt. You know, after 10 degrees, you can feel every notch. If it's 60, 64, you can't really, 30, 35, you can't. But when it's 10, you can be like, oh shit, that's 9. That's 8. 7, 7! And when it get 10 below, you don't want to do nothing because then in black ice, you can't walk because you don't know if it's black ice or it's ground. Like, is that the ground? <sighs> 17 more blocks. And white people, why y'all call it black ice? Just giving black people a bad name. It's not even black, it's see-through ice. Or white people ice. Y'all just wanna give us a bad name, watch out, there's nigger ice everywhere. If anything, it's Puerto Rican ice, gonna step up and gonna do this shit, adiós. Nosotros, vámonos! Feliz Navidad. Why the weatherman never tell you what you want to know fast? Right? He put us through this song and dance or this foreplay before he gets to the real shit. Like, all he want to know is going to be hot, cold, going to rain or snow, right? What's this other stuff he's saying? The northeast winds do west. We got pressures rise from southeast. Kilometers, Tepiamas, blown strong cold front. Push the windshield factory southeast westward. Building up pressure in the center. Should I wear my coat? What the fuck are you talking about? Should I bring my socks? Coat or no coat? Right? They should have a little man with his coat on, or a little man without his coat, so we can see immediately what we need to do. No one cares. No one cares about the humidity, the holometer. Oh, I made that one up. Wind chill. When I was little, I thought he was saying the windshield. I never heard of the wind chill, so I thought it was for people that be driving a car and the wind hit their windshield. And they gotta drive a certain way. Oh shit, the windshield. Let me drive this way. And when I was little, I used to tell my dad, Dad, watch out for the windshield. But you see, my family's from Haiti. My dad had no idea what I was saying. He was like, why you mean windshield? Windshield what? Who's she? Who's this she? No, windshield. Who your more dad, your sister? Why you say this she? What y'all talking about the windshield? What are you talking about? You ever hear the weatherman with that? It's 65, but with the windshield, it feel like it's 10. Well, the motherfucker is 10. Are you trying to trick us? Is this a test? How the hell is 65, but it feel like it's 10? Well, they feel like that's what it is. I'm supposed to wear two outfits, one for 65, one for 10? Ladies, like a guy told me I got a 2-inch dick, but it feel like it's 9. Stupid is 2, it's the windshield factor, girl. Get out of my house, windshield penis. It's the windshield penis. Huh? Sorry. Did you know a couple of years ago, what year was that? October 2010 was a historical month for black people. Did y'all know that? Because they finally named a hurricane after a black person. Hurricane Earl. You remember? Hurricane Earl is coming, motherfuckers. And just like a black person, he did not show up. Thank you. Good night. Wil Sylvince.
For more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs right now.
Have been great. Thank you so much. You guys have been a great. You guys have a good time tonight? Was this not awesome? You guys have been fabulous. We have so many people. We've discovered so many people here. Mexicans, Puerto Ricans, one Filipino girl. That was nice. That was awesome. A military guy. What was your military?
Navy
again. Kudos to you. Give him one more round of applause, you guys. Navy officer. You guys were fantastic. Absolutely. You're very pretty. You are the one Mexican. One, two, three. We're doing it, you guys. We're doing big things. We're taking over New York. Move over, Puerto Ricans. Watch out. Mexico's coming. There's Chipotle on every corner already, so. We're doing it. Doing it big Willy style, you guys. This is awesome. Puerto Ricans. Another thing about Puerto Rico. Tell me this, Puerto Rico. What is it with Puerto Ricans and their Mark Anthony? Because no matter what, like, my in-laws can seamlessly bring up Mark Anthony in any conversation at all. Like, my father-in-law will tell me, he'll be like, hey, the Yankees, they're gonna be good this year. But if they're not, it's okay. Mark Anthony, he's doing a special on TV. I'll record it for you. He's amazing, you guys. And my mother-in-law, she's very traditional. She just does all her coffee and her stories. It's amazing. You guys, let's hear it one more time for all our comics this evening. Let's bring them back up. They've been amazing. Jim Mendrinos, Luis J. Gomez, Nick Vatterott, and Wil Sylvince. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys.